Everybody, I'm Cindy with Natasos and More. Today we are going to be making a dress, or I guess you could say a costume. My granddaughter's in a play and tomorrow's dress rehearsal, so we have to make this for tomorrow, and she's going to be an Israelite girl. It's a Bible-based play, so I have everything here to get started. If you give me just a few minutes, do everything, and I'm gonna shut that shade because that's really annoying. There, much better. Okay, let me do what I have to do here real quick. I'm gonna share. It'd be nice if they made it a bit easier to do, but you know. Hi, Candy. Today we are going to be making a costume, a dress costume, and we're actually doing it from a pattern from almost scratch. So it's for Emma. She's in a play, and tomorrow is her first dress rehearsal. So we're going to be making it from the pattern. We have to cut it out and everything. Woohoo, exciting. I talked about yesterday what my least favorite was. Well, I think it's actually cutting out the paper part. Hold on, let me grab my computer. I did that part. Now let me get this turned on. Why? Okay. Well, you should have told me. Emma will be joining us at some point. She's doing a little. I guess I have to shut that other shade too. Hello, Aunt Flo. What? Hold on. I don't know what's going on here. Whoops. Okay, I'm getting there slowly. I'm moving a little slow today. Not sure of the reason why. Let me. And while I'm doing this, if you just want to go ahead and share, you can do that. Sharing does two things. It is nice so you can go back and find it on your thing. Emma, I can talk to Pop if you want to come here and talk to them. I'm sorry, my husband just called. Okay. And I think let me share one more place and then I am done with the sharing.
Yes.
Okay. So Emma's going to come around and she's going to talk to you. She can tell you a little bit about, she can show you which costume she's going to do.
Love you, bye.
And I'll show them on here which one, which costume you're going to do and a little bit about your play.
Hello. Nana, which one is it again? Nana.
Which one did you want?
I forget which one we were gonna do. This one or this one?
I don't know which one do you want. Get back in frame.
And we're gonna make this costume. So we're gonna make this costume for the live stream. So the dress that we're making is for my costume of an Israelite girl for a play I'm going to be in. Nana, can you bring me we're going to. So the play I'm in is about the deliverance from Egypt and Noah's Ark. And in the deliverance from Egypt scene, I'm an Israelite girl, so we thought this would work. So you said I can do all of this machine and
most of it. There'll be one thing that I'll have to do. Okay, sorry about that. Doesn't normally happen. He's away at work, so I really wanted to speak with him.
These ones are good. It's like candy.
All right, let me take this off the table.
Nana, it tastes like candy.
Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do, the first thing.
I chose this one.
Okay. So you told everybody which one we're doing? Mm-hmm. Oh. All right. Do you have brown sandals? That would be cute.
No, I don't.
Oh, well.
Unless I
can wear
one.
Your fancy, fancy ones.
No, maybe not.
All right, so this is what we're doing. So when you get a pattern, it comes with the directions. And it comes with this paper all folded up. Emma's unfolding it for us. Let me point you down.
This is really big.
Yes, it is.
I don't think that there's enough room. Oh, no, here's one of them.
We need to cut the large out, Emma, when we cut it out.
What's this one for?
Let me see, because I'll tell you what pieces. So, what you can do is... excuse me.
Here, do we need this piece?
I'm going to find out in 1 second. Inside the pack, can you shut that other shade, because it's making funky light. When you open up your pattern piece, I happen to be using McCall's 5905. You'll find on the back there are sizes, and you'll determine, you know, which size is yours. You can measure if you want. I tend to not measure, I guess, for the kids. For myself, you don't want to hear me. For myself, I have to measure. I'm never the size that it says, and I actually stopped sewing for myself because it got to be a little depressing. So what I'll do is, since she decided that she's doing, see, there's a letter. They all have letters next to them, so she's doing C. So I'm going to open up my paper, and see, there's letters on there. So it'll tell me which pieces I need for that particular thing that she's wearing. Okay. So we need pieces 1, 2, and 3. Is there any 1, 2, or 3 on there? And
No.
We also need 4. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4.
No.
Okay. So we can, yeah, we can set that piece aside. I'll fold it later.
We only need 1, 2, 3, and 4?
We only need pieces 1, 2, 3, and 4, so we don't want to have to cut anything else out. There's no sense in wasting our time doing that.
This one has 2 on it, so...
Okay.
This one has...
So you'll see on the patterns... They're noisy, I know. They have lines. We have a dash, long dash, short dash, long dash. We have just continual long dash, and we have a straight line. We're going to be cutting on the center one, the dash, dash, dash.
Not the 5, right?
No, yeah. Only up to 4.
I said that's...
Okay.
I was trying to tell what it was. I couldn't tell if it was a 4 or 5.
So I'm going to cut out...
And this one.
Number 2. Now, if you'll notice back here on this side, there's no line. What that means is it's for every size. And this is actually the center. What's it say? It's the center fold. How many of these do we have to cut out?
Okay.
Okay, so we only cut, it tells you right here. Cut one fold, and that's what this line means.
Okay.
Right here. I guess I don't really need to know that quite.
It says cut 2 of these, but what size is it?
You're going to cut this center mark right here.
Yep. It says cut 2 of them.
Well, that's when we get to the material.
I know.
But right now we're just cutting one.
Well, you can only cut one.
Right. So, and let me move you back so you can see what we're doing. My table is a mess. I don't know how I got all this junk all over it today. So you can see what we're doing. Excuse me. I think I need one of your things, Emma. Where are they?
Right there.
Thank you.
What's this?
It's what?
What are these?
I'll get to them later.
Okay, so I don't have to cut those.
Don't cut those yet. Don't do anything. Just cut straight around.
Okay. Please.
Everybody enjoying the nice weather today?
Does it go like this?
You come down. And that's a good thing. Let me show everybody that. So you can see on this piece, right here, comes down, and then she'll cut over and then come down. Because this is if you want to make the short sleeve version. But we'll keep it all together and use both.
So what am I doing? Oh, where did it go?
Cut down, go over, and then come down.
Nana.
Hmm?
Nana.
What, baby?
Nana, what?
Well, honey. You want to say hi?
No.
No. And sometimes in certain areas you gotta really pay attention because they
dining room.
You're talking to
Kayla. She wants to know where I am.
Oh, she wanted you. I don't know what for.
Coming.
Because sometimes the lines will crisscross. See what she wants to come back. She knows she's got a fever.
Rip it.
Yeah. Just be careful. I can tape it. And that's one good thing about this stuff. It rips, you just tape it. You cut it on the wrong line, tape it back together, cut it on the line that you need to cut it on. You can ask me how I know that. That's from experience. I've done it many a times. You know, some people say, cut out the biggest size and then cut around it and fold it and all that. I'm not bothered. It's too much work. Okay, so our first piece is all cut out, number two. And when I fold my pieces, I like to fold them so the numbers are out. So see, I'm trying to fold this up all nice and neat so that when I put them back in the package and I go to make this pattern again, if I ever make it again, my numbers are out and I don't have to unopen them to see what pattern piece I'm looking for. One, two, three, and four. Yep, I have one right here.
I got three and okay. Four.
So what I'm going to do, because there's a piece on here, number 18, I don't need it. So right now I'm going to cut along this bottom line so I can get 18 off, and that'll help a little bit not have so much paper.
3.
Okay. So see, she knows. Number out.
What's this?
That we don't need. So basically, what are you cutting out now? 4?
Mm-hmm, 4.
The sash, okay. Can you put this with all the other papers? Okay. I'm the squeaky chair. I meant to change them chairs around. Can you hear that chair squeaking? I know, Candy. Tomorrow's going to be even nicer. I'm hoping to get outside and walk. Yep, see, there's our little social eater again.
Huh?
The doggies. You know how they like to eat whenever I'm in the room. Now you know my business and you know who's calling. Oh well. Okay. Honey, I don't have to answer that, but thank you. Here you go.
Who is it?
It's for an appointment I have coming up. I'm just calling to remind me.
I think that this is the belt or the sash.
Yeah, it says it on there.
Oh.
What's it say?
Sash.
Mm-hmm. And my floor's creaky. I got a creaky house. My furniture's creaky, the floor's creaky, and I'm creaky. How funny is that? And overall,
it's hard to cut.
Overall, it doesn't take that long to do, as you can see. I mean, we're almost done cutting it out. I do also work with PDFs, which you print. That's something that I'm trying to learn how to do. Make my own patterns. I don't know how long it's going to take me, but one of these days. Whoops, got a little cockeyed there cutting. Are you scissor stall?
Huh?
Are you scissor stall or are you okay?
Okay.
So we just have one.
I'm just bad at cutting this paper.
Okay. We have one piece left to cut, and then we'll start cutting out the actual material.
Can I help also with cutting out the material?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. Emma will help me with that also, because this is her project. I mean, this is for her to wear, so she can have a, definitely have a big part in it. Let me hold this up to you. It looks like it's going to be so long.
What's this part?
This is the dress part.
The dress.
Okay.
Sure, it doesn't need a medium?
No, because it has a hem in it, so you're good.
Oh.
All right.
Are these the ones that you already, that we cut?
Yep.
Okay.
And I have the material over here. Let me grab that. Yeah. Emma, can you take these two things off the table? Allergies are really bad if you haven't noticed, and it is allergies for for sure. Okay. So this is going to be the actual dress or robe part, as you would say. This will be her sash. And she got this for the fringe. I'm not ready for that.
Man, it's the ones that I chose are actually pretty much the same except reversed.
Yeah. So I think Claudia got the one that we were looking at.
That we were.
I have to show you a picture. Back up. Let me move this chair.
So open it so that there's two for me.
I hope I have enough. Uh-oh, we might be running to Joanne Fabrics. I don't have it. How much did I buy? She didn't cut this right.
No, you got 2 yards. You asked for 2 yards.
Oh, I did, didn't I?
And you got 1 yard for the sash.
Hold on. So, well, let's talk about the... Oh, there's plenty there. Okay.
And, so, yeah, there's... Definitely.
There's more than enough. So, we have pattern piece number... one, and you can see right here it tells me that I want to cut 2.
Hey, Anna, can we do these scissors cut this?
They can, okay. But my scissors are in that basket for cutting.
You brought them.
I only brought one pair up though. I can use the yucky scissors. Okay. And this one tells you, and I think I mentioned it already, so cut 1 on fold. So we're going to cut this one on a fold. And the fold, how you know it, besides the fact it's a rotary cutter. I don't have my board to do it on there. I mentioned this little arrow thingy right here. That goes on the fold. That tells you that side is on the fold. So, what we want to do is we want to open this up.
Are we opening it now?
Like this. Yep. And we're going to fold it in to the center. Where's the center? Right here.
Center?
I think. Yeah, it says it's a center.
I guess it is. It doesn't look like this.
I know it doesn't.
But I guess it is.
Okay. And you actually... because it's a stripe, it's going to be easy to just fold it. I hope I have enough material here. I'll be devastated if I don't. All right, so we'll get you back to the middle. Okay, don't worry about it then. Don't come in here like that. Just walk away, remember? So, I mean, I went by the amount of fabric that they told me on the package. And that's the other thing. I guess I didn't show you that. On the back here, you'll find your size. And then you'll go by the amount that they tell you that you need. Can you pull the cloth so that there's no wrinkles in the table? The tablecloth. And let's make sure it's folded like this on this line. All right, and this one gets folded on the fold, is what I said, right? Is it this piece on the fold? Yep. And it doesn't matter if it's facing up or facing down. Doesn't matter if your fabric is right sides together or wrong sides together. What matters is that all your pieces are cut the same exact way. And I'm going to do it.
Gotta cut 4 of these.
For what? The sashes. Okay. Well, I'm not worried about them yet because they're made out of the other color, so. So I don't know if you can see. Let me just turn it this way just a little bit. Got my pins right here.
You cut two of these. This is the sleeve.
Okay. And this is right literally on the fold of the fabric right here.
Are those two the sashes?
This is the sleeves, right?
This says sleeves. This one says sleeves.
This is the back.
Okay.
Okay, this piece is the front.
So then that's all the we need for the stripes.
Mm-hmm. Can I have the pins, please?
Mm-hmm.
So I guess I did get short a little bit of the fabric, but that's okay because I'll show you how I'm going to remedy that. Because the back piece does not go on the fold, so that'll work out a lot. Let me get yourself a drink, Em. That might help. And then we'll start cutting, okay? I'll meet you in the middle when we cut. If you have a rotary cutter, you could use that. I find just doing it with my scissors works just as well for me. Not all patterns are equal. I find some are harder to understand than others.
I just got between my toes.
There are some patterns out there that I do not like, and I will not use their some companies I won't. I mean, but that's my personal preference. You would determine your personal preference also. Yeah, we'll both start cutting and then we'll meet
in the middle. So you didn't get enough fabric?
No, we'll be alright. It'll work. I can make it work.
I think that there's enough.
Mm-hmm. I think
it'll
work.
Put the back piece right here and then
that's
put
what I'm gonna do.
The three just in this area.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you cut this out, try not to cut onto the paper, okay? All right, so
okay.
We are ready. Let me find my scissors. Here we go. You got scissors? All right. Wait, let me put another pin right here so it doesn't move.
Do you need to put one right here?
No, let me put one there. Because when you start sewing, cutting, it won't. You'll think it's tight. It's not. Okay. So we're going to cut now.
So if it's a little bit over, but away from the paper.
Try and get as close to the paper. She's helping me right now, Kayla.
She's not 100% going to help.
Okay. I was going to try and cut this way. I just can't. I can't do it. Okay, let me finish from here. That's meeting in the middle. We just met in the middle. I'm going to take it the rest of the way down. And then we're going to take the pins out of this, because I don't have that many pins. Yeah. All right, Emma, come pull the pins out of this for me, okay? Okay, is that all the pins?
Yep.
Okay, so after I take all the pins out, I leave it on.
Oh, yeah.
That way I remember what piece this is. I don't have to try and line it back up on it and make sure that's it or anything. So. All right. Is that number one? All right. So since it's not directional fabric, meaning that it doesn't all go one direction, I will be able to do this. I'm going to go down just a little bit more. Just as long as I have enough for the sleeves, okay? That's all that matters in the end. Or zoom zoom.
Yeah. It's a zoom zoom.
Zoom zoom. I guess I'm thinking of like our come on and zoom 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 a zoom. Remember that show? Zoom. Oh, we may be making a trip to the ER.
Why?
I don't know. She's got some kind of concoction going on over there. She's stepping all around on.
Okay, there we go.
I mean, I'm getting over into the salvage edge a little bit, but that's not going to matter because we're going to be stitching that anyway.
Last time I didn't suck for very long because I forgot what it was and I started to bite it.
How's it taste when you bite it?
The same.
Oh, okay.
But you're supposed to suck on it to make it work better.
Yeah. And we'll talk about what all these lines and all mean in a moment. All right, I'm not cutting this. We'll cut the sash out next.
No, we'll cut the sleeves out next.
Oh, the sleeves, I'm sorry. Then the sash. Because I was just going to cut this out and sew, but I think it'd be easier if we just do everything all at once. Okay. Two more pieces in. I'm going to start cutting up here, and Emma can start cutting down there. That little bit, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like almost there. It'll work, trust me.
You said try not to cut all the paper, so.
You just don't cut right there, and there won't be no need to. Actually, I'll just start here and go up.
Is there enough pins right here?
Mm-hmm.
I can't find there not any pins.
Okay. I'll give you one of my pins in a second if you need it. Okay. These are not my normal scissors, so it's not cutting this nicely. I didn't feel like going downstairs and getting another pair. These are just my paper scissors, but they're working pretty good. That's another thing, you know, if you're a beginner sewer and you get scissors, you want to make sure that your fabric scissors are only for cutting your fabric. You do not want to cut paper or anything with your fabric scissors. That will dull them faster than anything. Might even ruin them, depending on what you cut with. So warn all family members. They do not cut with your fabric scissors. Okay.
You gotta cut this side.
Oh yeah.
Can you get it, or you want me to get it?
I need you to get it.
Okay. Just have to go around and make sure all the pins are up. You watch yourself.
Mm-hmm. Do you know what I'm doing?
What are you doing, honey?
I can't make it split it apart.
I'm gonna start pinning this in.
And there's something else I wanted to show you that I forgot to show you. They have an arrow for the grain line. Your grain line runs this way and this way. Usually you want your patterns to go that way. We don't have enough fabric for the sleeves to do that. It should be cut, it should be cut the other way, but that's okay.
I mean, it should be cut the other way.
The sleeves should be going in that direction, but I'm not worried about it. Number one, it's a costume. Number two, it's not the end of the world. And the reason why you want to have your fabric, your arrows go from cut end to cut end, is it has to do with, it has to do with draping, how it falls on your, on you when you're wearing it. Oops, forgot a pin. Wait a minute, is it, did the material unwrinkle?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I never
got out. Come over here, son. So we have this turned the opposite way. I don't know if you can see this. Technically, it should be going this way, but we're gonna have it going that way just because that's how the fabric ended up. And I mean, really, this is a costume. It's not gonna be something she's gonna wear, you know, afterwards. I mean, I don't know. It could come out really pretty and she might want to.
Wrinkled.
Hold on, let me straighten that piece out a little bit. Let's turn it around. You got it really buckled. It's gonna come out.
Yeah.
What?
There were pins.
There was? Oh, there sure was. Sorry. See, it's not. See how about? Let's pull this out for a second. Okay. Sorry. Start pinning up the side. So right here we have this little corner piece.
How come it's only on that side?
I guess you cut it off of that side.
It wasn't on that side.
Or was it? Okay, so I'm just going to fold it where it kind of comes out and then down like that. So where that little fold, you know, the little jut out starts, I guess you could call it. I'm going to fold it right there and pin it because we're making this long sleeve. If we'd wanted short sleeve, we would have left it.
We're making it long sleeve?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, it's long sleeve in the picture, isn't it?
I don't know.
Then they wore long sleeves then. Mm-hmm. I don't think they really wore short sleeves. That's good. I don't think we need. Oops, I didn't even pin. All right. I'm just going to cut that. And.
Oh, yeah. Here's the sash.
Yep. And. And see, our sash part says cut four.
much faster it goes when two of these are working together.
How do I even cut right here?
Because I just finally started cutting here. I'll get this. You go up there and finish. Okay? Is that good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. And I've got this right up to one of the salvages. I'm going to serge this. It's not important. You can sew it with a regular sewing machine, so don't even worry about that. Don't like, you know how it's folded in half? Don't open that part up. Keep it just folded in half. Okay, we got all the pins out. If not, we'll know in a second.
Why keep it folded in half?
Because of the, I'll show you.
We're cutting out four of them.
Yeah, I know. So, you know, normally when you buy your fabric, it comes in this width. And then,
it's
you know, they fold it.
In half this.
It's folded in, but this isn't half if you open it up, see?
Okay.
So, we're going to leave it folded like this. Let's see if that's all right with the sash. Can I see the sash? See if it fits in this area right here. Or if we have to open it up.
Does it have to be cut along it?
They actually want to cut the other direction anyway. Okay, take it off. Take it off. No. So they want it cut across this way. Can you fold that in half and let me see?
I fold it in.
If it fits right here, fold it in half. Mm-hmm. Sure does. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to fold this like this. So I'm just going to fold this in half and cut it on the fold because that will make it much easier since it is the same exact size, you know, from side to side. See, we're doing it on the fold of the fabric right here. Because I think if she's going to want that piece to wrap around the top, we're going to need that piece also. But I didn't see that. Let me look on the back because sometimes they... Probably should have come closer to this part so I didn't waste as much up here, but I'll hold on to it. I could probably incorporate it into a sash on a quilt or something. Okay, that can get folded.
Watch the pins. All right, well, now we are ready to begin sewing. Yeah, it's a pretty good size, so I'll be able to recycle this into a waist sash. Just trying to look at this. All right, so I'm done with this piece. Yeah. Oh, I only cut two, didn't I?
You only cut two.
Oh, how silly of me. I gotta cut two more. What was I thinking?
That big piece that I folded.
I see one of them.
While it's folded or while it's open?
I need it folded. Mm-hmm. All right, let me see. Okay. I can see the cut. So I'm just going to put this on here and use this as my piece because it won't move like the paper would move. Then I don't have to pin. No. Okay. There we go. Now how many pieces do I have, Emma? Better tell me four. All right, let's fold this up. Leave them folded, please, and stack them. All right.
One.
All right, so.
Two.
It's a shame you can't, can't recycle fabric in the recycling can. All right. So what they're going to tell us to do is the first thing you want to do is get piece number one. So let me get my serger.
Do you need your sewing machine?
No, I want my serger first.
Okay. Then you're going to need to bring a chair over to here.
Why?
Because you're serging and I'm sewing too.
No, I'm going to serge first and then we'll sew.
Okay. I just want to sit.
You can sit in the other chair. Spent a lot of time the other day. Can you bring the camera closer? Like right here. Whoa! Ooh. Let's make everybody dizzy. I spent a lot of time the other day getting this all set just right. I hope those settings are. I need a scrap piece of that material.
Which one?
Give you a view of my ceiling. Okay. And make sure everything looks okay still. This is going to be noisy, and I'll try not to shake the table too much.
inside that bag I have my little scissors. Will you get them, please?
Mm-hmm. Our scissors doesn't shake as much as the other one.
What, the sewing machine?
Mm-hmm. As much as the other
one. Oh, yeah. Okay. Beautiful. It's a beautiful stitch, nice and tight. So what they want me to do is they want me to sew down the back from the dot down. But I want to completely serge my ends, and then I'll go back in with the sewing machine and do that. Excuse me. So I probably won't do it right away. It won't hurt if I go in and do that later by any means. Okay, so, and the reason why I serge, and it's not something you have to do, but it makes the ends, and I'm not going to trim any off, as little as possible anyway, it makes the ends, it's a nicer finish, like when you purchase your clothes in the store.
Beautiful.
I think it's okay. Try not to make this sick shaking the table. Wondering if I should sit it up on the floor. So look at that. See how nice that finishes the edges? And that'll keep it from fraying. But like I said, if you don't have a serger, you don't have to do that.
Are you putting it on the ground?
No, I'll be right for a few minutes. Now, Emma, why don't you look at the directions and tell me what we're supposed to do next?
What step are we on? And where are we at?
I'm doing number one.
Alright. 5/8 of an inch. Is that what it is?
Yeah, 5/8 of an inch.
Seam narrow allowed. Hem at back edges, squaring stitching below.
Okay. Here's the other piece. So what does it tell me to do? Can't see. Okay, what am I doing now?
You're doing the wrong dress.
No. Which dress are we doing?
C. This says...
All these.
Dress B.
Oh, hold on. Sorry. No, that's for... It says robe or dress B. Directions 4. See, she's reading this up here. It says for the robe, A, B, C, D, blah, 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 and then dress B. What's the difference between dress B and robe? It's all the same thing. I don't know. They both look the same to me, so I'm not sure what the difference is.
Different colors.
There is a difference in there anyway. We might wing it as we go along.
There is?
There's nothing wrong with doing that. You can. So...
Oh, well.
So then it tells you to stitch down the back, which I'm not going to do till we pull the sewing machine out. I'm going to try and do as much as I can on here before we switch it around because my cords don't reach. So we're going to stitch the shoulders together now. So I need number 2. I'm going to hold this because I'll need it for marking later. Can you get me piece 2, please? A doesn't tell me where 5/8 is, so I have to guess where 5/8 is. Okay. So we're going to stitch the front and the back together. So when you do this, you're going to put your right sides together. Okay, so we're going to open this up. And I'm going to put the right side up. And then, this is your center back, so you want to make sure this goes to the middle. So it's going to go on this side. And then this one goes on this side here. See where we're matching up the shoulders. And I have an idea of what 5/8 is, so. Okay, let's do this side now. Try and pay attention, because let me tell you, there is nothing worse than picking a serge seam apart. Okay, so those, it's done. The front shoulders are done. Look how beautiful that seam is. All right, now we have to go down the sides. Not having a stitch guide there. Pre-washing. I do not pre-wash. Some say you have to because of shrinkage. Some say that you don't. I guess if you have something you know is going to really shrink bad, I would. More than most likely, I would just wash it in cold water and hang it to dry. That's what I do with most of my clothes anyway. So that side is sewed. And then what do you do next, Em?
Are we on step three now?
Nope. Well, we should be doing this. I guess we are going to have to pull the sewing machine up. Because in order to do this next step, we need the sewing machine for that.
See, now it's in that order for a reason.
Yeah. Actually, I think I'm gonna skip these steps and go right to the shoulder and put the sleeve in. And then I'm gonna put the sleeve in before we do the neck area. Okay.
That all these pins are magnetized to it. It was upside down.
Oh, was it?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I get sewing. I make a mess. I get stuff everywhere.
Why?
about you putting it around the electronics?
Are these the neck areas?
Now, what they want me to do now is they want me to put a binding around here, and I do have some binding to put on there. But I'm going to wait. I'm going to put the sleeve on first. Because like I said, I want to do everything that we need to do with the serger, as much as we can do with the serger, and then we'll move on to the sewing machine. So I'm skipping around a little bit. It really will not hurt it. Right now what I'm going to do is do what they call stay stitch the neck so that it doesn't stretch out of shape on me. Just went around the neck, and that'll help keep it a little bit neater. Now the sleeves. Where's the sleeve gear? Whoops, got a pin. Can you give me my water, please? Thank you. Okay, so there's two ways you could do the sleeves, and I kind of wish I had done it the other way. Usually you can put the sleeve in before you sew and then sew, you know, up, but I didn't do that. I'll do it. So I'm going to do the set-in version instead of the easy version. I think I'm going to like the sleeves reversed like this, Em.
Huh? What do you mean reverse? Anna.
Huh?
What do you mean reverse?
This stripe should have been going this way.
Oh. Oh well.
Aside. Now let's do the next sleeve. Annalise watching Polly Pocket in there. I don't know if you can hear it. Sure you can. Nice. How's it feel on you? Not too tight or anything?
Actually, perfect. Okay. I have to turn it the right way.
Yeah, go ahead and turn it the right way. Oh, I wish I had serged this first. Well, I'm not going to be serging the sleeve and the cuffs then. But we'll be tucking them up, so it's okay. So we're going to turn the sleeve so that the right side is out now. And I'm gonna need the pins. I'm gonna pin this inside here and then we're gonna serge it. So we have the right side out like this. Look at that. Almost lined up perfect.
Nana, the stripes almost touch each other.
These ones do here.
It's kinda cool.
Hi, Rachel. How are you? How are you feeling? We're making a, Emma is in a play. So we're making her, and it's a Bible-based play. So we're making her her little outfit. She's going to be an Israelite girl.
Do you know what dress it is that we're making?
Sure.
Which one are we making?
I don't know. One of them. Doesn't matter. They're all like the same.
And this is the dress that we're making.
So I'm just going to pin this around. You can see, I mean, we're moving along fairly quickly. Let's see, oh, I have to ease it in. It doesn't talk about that.
Yeah, we have been live for 1 hour, 12 minutes, and 31 seconds. Mm-hmm.
So, let's see. Let's put the sewing machine over here, Emma, on this spot, because we do need it for the arms, for the sleeves.
Yay, we're starting with that.
Turn my printer off.
Why do you have to turn your printer off?
Because I gotta unplug it. Okay, so Emma is going to do a running stitch. Let me see the sleeve. Yeah, the TV got a little loud. So from this dot to this dot. So what I would do, thank you.
Hi, Mommy.
Where's my sleeves?
Where's the, I can't find the color.
Oh, that was underneath.
I lost it.
So I could have done this beforehand. This probably would have been the best time to do it, but that's okay. So the stitch length, you're going to put it in the on the longest setting. Hi, Liam. So I just kind of, that was my center point, so I know on here, and I'm going to line that up with these center circles, and I'm going to come around to right where these dots are, put my finger there, put a pin in there.
Do you have to change the thread? It's dark.
That'll be all right for what we're doing.
I mean, now there's no dark blue in there.
And then I'm going to put my finger and kind of match up where that one is there. You're going to put it on the longest stitch that you can.
The longest stitch?
Mm-hmm. Your stitch length. This button right here.
Oh.
Which is 5 on my machine. She's going to...
I'm going to...
So from here... to here, and try and stay along the edge the best that you can. Okay. And I'll get the other sleeve ready for you. See, I'm really bad about reading directions. I'm a picture person. I look at the pictures and then I'm like, oh no, I really should have done this.
So from this pin to the other pin?
Yep. Don't back stitch or anything, just sew.
Just sew?
No back stitch.
Making the knots?
Nope.
Okay.
I'll take care of all that when you're done. okay. Once it's sewed, I don't need the pins.
Yeah.
And you're going to do the same exact thing with this one.
How's that look?
Fine.
I thought I was closer to the edge.
Yeah, wow.
Because it confused me because the pins farther over than the side of the thing.
All right, so I'm just going to tie these in a little knot. Let me bring you back to me. Why what? Is there
this
center? Alright, here, I'll do it again.
Also, why did you put a center one on this
one? Because I needed to know where the center was to line up with the dot. Here, you don't need the center pin. Alright. So we're done with that for now. So, you see she has the running stitch along here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just give it a little knot. I don't want it to do something too much so we don't pull it out. Once it's sewed in, we can pull that running stitch out, but until then. So you want to grab, they tell you the bobbin, but I grab it from either side. For me, it works just fine. Okay. You could do a little back stitch at the beginning to hold it in place, or,
the stitch,
you know.
Came out.
You mean it came out?
Like, it was all the way over here, but it went to here.
Okay.
And then I didn't cut it all the way.
All right, so her stitch came out. So what I'm going to do, all right, since her stitch came out, we're just going to pull the whole stitch.
Redo it.
He's trying to talk to us. What are you talking about, Liam? Okay. There you go. So where was I? So I'm just pulling it and I'm gathering it. And I'll adjust it even better once I get it inside here. Let me find one. And it, the sleeves don't matter. There's no right or left on it. They're both the same, I think. Yeah, they're both exactly the same. Just pin this around. And I'm going to go all the way up. Thank you.
It'll come out this time.
I'm going to go all the way up to where the where it started, and I'm going to stop there with my pins. I'm going to do that on this side also. And then I'm going to stop where that one started. All right, so you can see how, you know, it's too big and we pulled the one string. So I'll just keep pulling it and adjusting it until it lays in here just right. I'm going to be careful how hard I pull because I don't want to pull it out from the other side. See this here? And let's see. Now let me just kind of pin this. All right, now I'm going to serge this. I need to be very careful of the pins. That will ruin your blade on your serger if you run it over. So I'm going to lay it like this. And got my serger foot. And here we go. You want to make sure it's smooth and not wrinkled. Okay, now I'm coming up to my gathers. I don't know if you can see that here. And I just want to kind of make sure they are smoothed out nicely. Pull out any pins, make sure there's none hidden inside the gathers there. I have run pins over before, trust me. It's scary. It sounds scarier than it actually is. Well, Liam, was that you talking?
I guess so.
Liam, why don't you give me some hearts? Give me some hearts and some thumbs up. Okay. So there is our first sleeve. There we go. Now we're going to put the other sleeve in. And then she'll give us a quick view of a little bit of what it looks like. And we can actually start sewing at the same time. I can work on the sash while she works on the sewing this together.
He gave a real thumbs up with his thumb.
Oh, push the little thumbs up. Liam, give me love. Give me some love.
He's giving
me
some love.
Oh, thank you. Watch pushing the pedal. And you want to match your seams. This is your underarm seam on both sides. That's what I'm doing. And I have one folded this direction, and this one folded in the other direction. And I want to, I put them together, and you can kind of feel them lock into place right there. So that's what I'm trying to do. Liam, did you give me that angry face? I'm just seeing if I missed any comments.
Did you?
No. Just checking though. Checking to make sure. Yes, baby. What do you got, Annalie? What do you have, Annalie?
I can have a touchy
ball. Oh, are you? So, we are moving like, oh, I forgot to knot one side. Let me tie a little knot on this side. Because when it's all over, I want to be able to rip it out if it can be seen. I don't remember if you could see it on the other side. I'm thinking maybe not. Let me see. Oh no, you don't see it at all.
I'm not someone else comments something, will it show up because you're not in the right spot? You didn't go all the way down.
Yeah, I did. Oh. All right. This is what happens when you wait till the last minute and she's going to have this for tomorrow. It's kind of like doing your homework, your essay or your report the night before it's due, basically. And it isn't because she hasn't been here because of this horrible cough. I don't know what I was thinking of. She's going to keep me up all night. Have to listen to her cough. But I love her. So it'll be worth it.
Lou, Liam's talking to you.
Oh, yes, Liam. How about Madison? Hi, Madison. Okay. Now, there's that one right there. I just did it. So, let's start sewing this one in.
Gotta sew anything else?
Not yet. In a few minutes, you will be.
Do it.
I was just asking. How many times did I do this?
Once.
Okay.
So just do it once and daily.
I thought I ran over a pin for a second. Scared me.
Now he's sending you emojis.
He's too cute. I don't know why he's sending me an angry face. Probably because he's not here with his Nana. He's sad.
That's
angry.
What I was going to say. Maybe because he didn't let him stay.
Yeah, he's ready to go. All right, why don't you stand up and try this on just for a little bit of a model right here.
All right. This is going up some, right?
What?
At the bottom?
Yeah, I'm going to hem it. So that's a little bit of what we have so far. Looks pretty good, actually. Turn around. So we're going to stitch this down the back, then we're going to have this will get folded in, and I'm actually going to put, it said you could put like Velcro, but I think I'm just going to put snaps. I know they didn't have snaps back in those days, in the Israelite days, but we're just going to put a snap in, and we got to hem the sleeves,
yes.
Which I'll probably have to do, Emmy, because they're so tiny.
Hem?
Yeah.
Well, if it's hemming. Is the hemming on this or so?
Well, I would like to do it on here, but the sleeves are just too tiny. So now what I'm going to do, and you can mark these with, there's special pens to mark with and all that, but.
Thank you, Aunt Candy.
Thank you.
Oh, I accidentally plugged it. Pushing my chair in.
So what we need to do on the other piece is, I could have done it earlier and I could have put a pin in it. This circle right here, I'm going to mark it, and that's, she's going to sew from that point down. So let me show you. Your stitch length, put it on about 3.5.
3.5?
Yeah.
The length, like,
yes.
Put up to 5.
So I'm gonna lay this down here like this. You can see what I'm doing. Basically, like I did this sleeves. Nothing's been cut, so everything should line up fairly good. Right about here is where they want you to start. So let me do that. Okay, do you think you need me to pin this, or do you think you can just stop and line it up?
I think I can stop and line it
up. Okay, so let me take you over to Emma.
Since I don't go that fast.
For a few minutes?
Okay, so what am I doing?
And it's alright that it's the blue thread. Nobody, where's the pin? Here it is.
It kind of matches with it, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it'll blend in. Watch yourself. I'm going to put it on the center. I'm going to start right here.
Where am I sewing?
All right, let me get her a piece.
Am I just sewing to the bottom? Until I get to the very end.
Yeah, you're gonna go all the way to the end. But let me get you something, a piece of tape or something.
Oh, so that I.
So she knows where her stitch line is.
Yeah, I remember we did that one time. So I know where I keep this at.
Mm-hmm. This is like a piece of wasabi.
Wasabi.
Tape because it doesn't leave residue. So you're just going to sew right along that. And that's going to be her.
It's not even.
Well, then make it even. That's going to be her thing telling her how to stitch. So while she is doing that, I'm going to.
Work on the sash?
Work on the sash, which should be next. I can find those directions.
Wait, I need to leave it out this time.
Yeah, this time you do go backwards. Where's the other? Oh, here it is. Why they had you do four pieces for the sash was because, and I don't think there's a right or wrong side with this, but we'll just keep all the insides together. They want you to join two together so that she can have a really long sash. Do that with this piece also. Tease us the cake. Let me see the cake.
No, I saw it.
Ooh, here, show. Look at this cake somebody gave Lisa.
I opened it.
So pretty and purple.
It smells so good.
Let me smell.
Let me smell. Oh my God. I opened it earlier to see what
was in it. I want some cake.
Can
I'm sad. I don't have any cake. Okay. So now we get to put these two pieces together. And if you notice, my threads are not making a difference. You're never going to. And when you do sew with a serger, the only thread essentially in the end would be the very first one that if your seams pulled, you would see. There's not going to be any stress on these seams, so I'm not worried about that. Again, I have this one going this way, and I will lock them together.
Now, when I get to the end, do I just sew off or do I stop and then?
Go back a little bit.
Sometimes you say just go right off.
Yeah, I know. I'm not going to do a seam allowance on this one. They want you to leave an opening for turning, so I'll start right about here. Are there sprinkles on it? Is that what you said? Did it run out of bobbin or something? What do you mean it stopped?
It ran out of bobbin.
Okay, I'll take care of that.
Right here.
Oh, almost to the bottom. That stinks.
I can just stop. Whoops. Right back up there.
Well, you got to fill the bobbin, but you need to fill it with red thread.
With red thread?
Yeah, so that when we go to sew this, you have the right thread in. Or just grab a bobbin out of the arm.
White?
Any color.
Well, I can just fill it back with this blue and finish this with the same color.
There's another blue in there?
No, but can't you fill it? What? So you just do a white one?
Over here to where we're at.
It's not in here anymore.
Okay. Probably just came out. So press your foot up.
Oh yeah, I need to put this back on anyway.
Did you get it in?
Yeah.
You didn't. There's no thread sticking out, so it's not in. You have to put it in, go through here, 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 and then pull it, and it cuts it.
That's what I did.
Oh okay. Sorry.
That's the exact thing that I did.
Alrighty. Okay. Alright. Go ahead and finish. So, what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to bring you a little bit closer, is I'm going to make sure this one is facing this way and the underneath one is facing the same way.
Just thing comes open.
Take your fingers away from the machine.
Yeah,
what do you want to do? You want to say hi?
I want to chew.
But I am working with the machine. I want your fingers to get caught. She wants to show you the bow she found. She found a red bow. Okay. Off right there, and here's my opening for turning. They have you leaving a bigger opening.
Do I have to turn this the right way now?
Yeah, turn it inside out. I don't think it's necessary to leave. The bigger the opening, the more I have to.
It's not inside out, it's right way.
Or right side out, yeah. She's got it pretty much sewed. So basically, all that we have left now is
the sleeves not being
the same. Yeah, I like the sleeves the way they are too.
Do you want me to try it on again?
Yeah, it's up to you. I'm going to see if a snap will work on the back. If not, then I'll have to do it something different. All right, so I'm turning it inside out. Should have had it more this way. There we go. Now, I'll have to press this, which I'm not going to do until I'm going back into the hole again. Until later tonight, I'm not going to bore you all with pressing. Why?
I'm putting it on.
Well, you're not going to. You're not. You're just going to wear like a tank top under it and like white shorts or something. Why?
We're wearing our normal clothes on.
I was just going to push like a tank top for you, okay. Like the spaghetti strap tank top underneath both your outfits if you wear a white one. Well, yeah. Or you could just stay in your outfit.
No, I'm talking about for the play.
You need normal
clothes? For the
paradise. Oh, yeah.
You need our normal clothes. How's it look?
It's looking really, really cute. Now, here you go. Let's look at it again. And then come here.
Is this the sash?
This is going to be the sash.
And how does it go over on my head?
We don't have that piece. That'll be her.
That piece doesn't come with it?
I haven't read that far. And there is, that'll be the sash. And of course, we're going to have the fringe along the bottom of it. So that'll be really cute. All right. Now turn around. Let me see the back if I'm able to put a. It's a little tight on you, Em. Or you just didn't have it on right. If I put a snap on it, is that too tight?
No.
Or I'll just put like a hook and eye is what I'll put there. An eye hook. Okay, let me have this.
Ta-da. Looks weird.
Let me have this. And now we can start hemming everything. And then we need to top stitch this. I don't understand.
Sorry.
So I'll pin that if you want to hem it. Okay.
Hem it?
Yeah.
I mean, I said I couldn't hem it.
You can do the bottom hem.
Oh, you said I couldn't do the sleeve.
Well, I mean, you might be able to. We'll see. And we still got to do around the neck. Yes. That's who has it?
Mama, put the outfit on me. Put the outfit on me.
So, let's do our hem.
Is the hemming on the sewing machine or on here?
It's on the sewing machine.
I figured that.
But I am going to run a stitch around the machine real quick. That way we don't have to fold it twice. We can just fold it once. I'm opening my seam up. And we're coming right back. Okay. Now we're going to hem it. I don't think she needs a big hem in it. This I will pin. So, see, I'm just folding it up. But because I did this, I don't have to do a double fold.
Is this where I have to take this off so that I can put it around it?
You don't have to. How long was it on you? Was it real long, right?
Maybe to, like, here.
Yeah, so we don't have to put
it... It, like, came to here and then it went...
Okay, well, we don't have to put a big hem in it. You're still on 3.5, right?
No.
What do you want now?
2.5.
Okay. Maybe that's from when you turned it off and had to turn it back on.
How was the cake?
And I'm kind of finger pressing as I go along. So I probably won't hem the sleeves on air live. I will do it afterwards, you know, and I'm going to, while she's hemming, I'm going to run down and find a button to put on here. That's cute. Or some kind of closure. Now see, we have this little thing. I'll just tuck that down and in.
On a headband.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that would be cute. Hope my hem is even. If not, I'll be rehemming. All right, Emmy, it's all yours. So Emma's going to hem it now, and I'll bring you close to her, and you can watch her.
I didn't know if it was the one where I took this off, like the shark tail.
Oh. Because
it was easier.
Yeah. You don't have to.
Okay.
All right, so just start wherever. Where'd the tape go? Well, I mean, basically, also, you just keep... You don't need the tape. Just keep this along here, okay?
Oh, and I don't need it.
Yeah, you don't need it. I'm going to run down and get some kind of closure while...
So am I just going all the way around?
Yeah, go all the way around. Okay. Back stitch. Don't forget the back stitch.
Uh-huh.
Decided how I'm going to put this snap on.
Are you
going
to use one of the colors? Are you going to use your stamping thing?
Yeah. This. Okay. Now for the drape. What did you tell us about the drape? It might go in the package. Got the robe, we got the sash, and we got the vest. Nowhere does it mention cutting out the drape.
Didn't even have a pattern for cutting it out.
No. Okay, it probably just tells you dimensions, and that's what will be the rest of our robe will be for. So, while she's working on that, let me talk about the key a little bit. Guess I should have done that at the beginning. You have all these different symbols and they mean different things. This one is the right side of the fabric. This is the wrong side of the fabric. The little dots, it's the interfacing. And these would be your linings. The right side of the lining and the wrong side of the lining. So when you're looking at pictures, you can see how this one is showing you the outside, and these would be the inside. Let me look on the package. Maybe the package talks about the sash. Or the drape.
How's it look, Nana?
Nice job. She did a really good job on that. Oh, well, don't worry. Once we press it, it'll press out okay.
Why does it look like that?
Because you caught part of it in it. You have to take that out and fix it. You did it in a couple spots. You didn't make sure it was straight. Okay, here's a perfect example of what we don't want to do. And I have done this. Emma is not the only person. I've done it more times than I could count. She caught the fabric in it. So we need to take the stitches out carefully. And she'll have to go back in and re-stitch.
Re-stitch just that part, or mm-hmm. re-stitch
no,
the whole thing?
Just that part. Now, trust me, this is way easier to deal with than on a serger, because sometimes on a serger it can ruin your whole outfit. No, you do not. Connelly is so cute. The other night, I was like, oh, I'm having a hot flash. And she was sitting there, and a few minutes later, she goes, Nana, I'm having a cold flash. I'm cold. Yeah, she was so cute. She probably had a cold flash because I turned the fan up real high. Okay, I've almost got it back.
You had a cold flash.
So, I'll show you my ideal that I came up with.
So, what are you going to do with this?
You know, if we did, like, the crowns or anything like that, the interfacing would, okay. So here you go. Whoops. Here you go. So you're going to start here and go all the way over to basically this seam. So start here. Start right here where my finger is. And be careful that it doesn't get folded up in it, okay?
Then I have to do it like this.
What do you mean?
How do I...
Okay, let go.
If I go from here to here...
Okay. Well, then just start at the seam right here and go around to where you, to this seam. Just sew from seam to seam. That'll be your best thing to do.
From this seam?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what I'm trying to figure out is they have a sash, but they don't, they tell me to cut it, but they don't tell me, well, I guess they want it 5/8 inch wide. And the width of the fabric is going to be my guess. Oh, no, they said cut that one a yard and a quarter. Okay, so we'll do that. And let's see how much we have left. I know we have at least that, so, because, show you a little trick. My nose, and if I turn my head this way, to the tip of my finger is a yard. So we have about a yard and a quarter
yet
left.
Anywhere else?
Nope. Perfect. So we have about a yard and a quarter left. So we have exactly enough. So basically, the only thing I really want to do is make sure my ends are nice and straight.
Now we just need to do the sleeves.
Yeah. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to do with how I'm going to do this snap. This is just a little something I came up with in my head. I'm basically just trying to straighten this out a little bit.
Huh? That was confusing.
And this end. This is probably where my rotary cutter would have came in, because I could have done that way, way faster with a rotary cutter. Okay, so I straightened my ends out, basically. Could have even put them together and done them that way. So the directions tell us for the drape. You're going to stitch the two short. I need a... And then I want to just put ribbon around it and all that. Basically, it's done similar to the sash around the thing. We're not going to work on the drape today. I'm not going to hem it at all. You can wear it tomorrow like that because it's getting late. I mean, it's done like the sash. So I'm going to top stitch this real quick. Emma, why don't you get out the fringy stuff?
Oh. And what do you mean? So are
Why
you gonna
tangle it too much?
Are you gonna hem the sleeves? Are you gonna hem the sleeves, or are you gonna wait?
No, I can hem them real quick. I have no idea.
Are you gonna do the drape for tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're just not going to have the stash.
Okay. So, can you tilt that up? Tilt that towards me, please. I need to real quick just.
How's that?
Good. Can you put that in my basket, please? I got a little bag for carrying stuff up and down the steps.
What's this?
That's going to be a break. You can just put it on for tomorrow for just the sake of putting it on.
How do I put
it? More of it. We actually need some more of it. We don't have quite enough.
How do I put it on? Like this?
Got to open it up. It's not out here on the table that I know of.
Here.
Thank you. Go, goodbye.
Whoops.
No, that is done.
Well, it's her. She played with it today.
So how do I put it on?
Well, I'll show you in a minute, Emma, when we put your whole outfit on. Which should be in about, hopefully in about 10 minutes. We will be at the point. Bring the camera closer, please. I didn't think so.
Tilt it down.
All right, so we're gonna stitch very close to the edge here. We're gonna top stitch. So I'm gonna move my needle over. Okay, and that'll be a nice top stitch. To take this in to be serviced, I could tell.
And then you're never gonna get it back.
I know. Well, my serger's done.
Oh,
yep.
After you get another one?
Mm-hmm. That's all right, I got a backup. That's good. That's a good thing. All right, so we're gonna stitch all the way around, and I'm gonna show you what we do when we get to the opening. We want to come close to the edge to about where we think we are, the same amount at the corner. Turn it. Lift your needle and turn it.
I'm gonna get the more.
Mm-hmm. Make sure it's nice and flat.
Come on, puppies.
It would be easier if this was pressed. I could go much faster. I wouldn't have to sit here and fool with it like this. Especially once the fringe is on here, that's going to be super adorable. Huh? Yeah. you're free to try it on.
Yeah, I'm saying candy.
Oh, I think so. I mean, unless you can find a one-day dry cleaner, which you might. The one in Fox Run isn't that bad. I like them. So, you can see right here, wait, let me sew a little bit more, I can show it to you.
She finished all the episodes in like a week.
Okay. So you see we have the opening. So all I'm going to do is fold it in, and then as I go around and top stitch, it will sew it down. Get this corner poked out. Open this side because this side's already flat and that'll help me go faster. I'm coming up onto the opening.
Yeah. Did you tell her that the sleeves come up onto the wrist? Like when you put it on, you can put this on your wrist.
And I don't know where the other one is, so I'll have to not use them. Off. Yeah. Unless I'm sure it's down there somewhere.
Somewhere.
Okay, so I have my piece folded in. My opening. You'll never be able to know that I had an opening there. Well, unless you know it's there. You might not be able to find it. I wonder if you'd be able to find it.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
See it right here.
Dude, the hem is good. Hem is perfect. Turn. Keep turning. Oh yeah, it's perfect. Mm-hmm. Okay. How about this piece? You don't like it? Well, it's not complete. No, you want it to go up higher?
Like it? I mean,
this is a dress that I did last night. Can I show you? Well, I don't know if I want to show you because then you'll see how dirty the kitchen is. But oh well. There we go. And that's the dress that I had. Well, I mean, it did come out a little bit. It pulled out, but I can take it a little bit higher. But I don't think it looks bad. Like, you can't really tell once I stitch it completely. Wow. All right. Is this zipped all the way?
No, I'm zipped.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
As far as it can go.
All right. And that's what I did last night. And there's the, you can look down and see the beautiful hem. perfect. It's actually perfect length. It's all right. I have plenty of jewelry. I'm gonna pick something. She does? Earrings too. All right, so I'm almost done. Emma, are we ready to put the trim on? Trim?
Trim,
fringe, whatever you want to call it. All right. Look, my baby joining us. You see her sitting there. I get your mommy, baby. Oh, look, and here comes Jealous. You want to come up and say hello, too? Say hello to everybody. Say hello.
Put their tutus on them.
I don't know where their tutus are. Back up. Okay, so now, that's my pile of trash. We're going to put this on. And of course, they tape it because it does come undone. Never worked with this before, so this will be new to me. So I'm going to assume I need to stitch this end back and forth real quick. Here, trade spots. Entertain.
Yeah, that's what they said you have to do.
Do a dance. Entertain everybody.
Can I pick out the snap that I want?
Sure.
I want it to be yellow.
Yellow?
Okay. I don't know why, but that was the first color that I wanted it to be. That popped into my eye was yellow.
A little zigzag.
I think I changed my mind on what color I wanted. Because I forgot. I want this color right here.
Oh, I'm hoping that holds this. It'd be terrible for her fringe fell off, wouldn't it?
Yes,
all right, watch out, Emma.
Which ones do I have to get out?
I'll worry about that. You just worry about the color that you want.
Oh, I know which ones I have to get out. Never mind.
Okay. So I just stitched right here. I did a little zigzag right there. And
there's only two different types you have to get.
We're going
to
put this right on here, like this. I almost wonder if we should.
Can I do this part?
Wrap it around and do both sides. That'd be, yeah, we're going to wrap it around and we're going to actually do both sides. I think that would look nice. So let me stitch this one like right there and there. Now let me sew this back and forth and then Emma can sew this on if she wants.
I sewed it. Okay. Love to sew it on.
Oh, there's a clip too. Did you know that?
A clip?
Yeah, there's a zipper and a little.
Yeah.
It's just come off.
I don't know what you're talking about. So.
Well, the clip, yeah. The hook.
You know, yeah, the eye hook.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's like it's the zipper.
Yeah.
Are you about to sew the one?
Yeah,
there's
the
dress.
Okay, so. And then they say to pull out the bottom part.
Yeah. Bottom part. I don't want this to fall apart, so let me move this over here neatly to right here. Thanks, Candy. I think it is so pretty also. So what I'm going to do is lay this on here, and it's going on the edge. Where's my pins?
Right
I don't know. I think they're right here
because
I was using
them.
Yep, they're
right here. If it's too much and too hard for you to sew through all this, let me know, please, okay?
I will.
And you need to put it back to a straight stitch because I put it on a zigzag to sew the ends.
Put it on 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4.
For the straight stitch? Mm-hmm. Number one.
Okie dokie. Wasn't sure. Does the length have to be changed? It's on
2.5. Go to 3. I like to sew on 3.5. That's just my personal preference.
3.5.
Oops. That popped out. Back in. Okay, so now Emma's going to sew this on, and while she's sewing this on, I'm going to work on getting the other.
Woo! So how do I sew the one?
Just do a straight stitch.
Okay.
Pull the pin out. If you don't think you can do it, let me know.
Okay.
Because there's two layers there. So you need to make sure you get through both layers. Ew, what is this? Something sticky. I don't know what that was.
How are you looking at?
I don't know. So then we want to do, where's that piece right here? Yeah, I want to be careful with that. We want to do this piece. I'm going to sew this, and then I'll do the same thing where I'll come in.
I almost sewed on a very fast one.
Oh. Whoops, that was the wrong end anyway. I'm going to sew up here. Put that there. And if we wrap it around.
I can just go back and do the knot, right?
Mm-hmm.
Am I kidding? Okay. Because I forgot.
Okay. All right. So I'll have to get a piece of tape and tape this before I do anything else with it later, or that will all come out. Trust me. Did you get it, babe?
I'm about to do the knot in the beginning. Because I did it. I forgot.
You know what might be better? Here, lift up. See, let me show you what she's doing over here so you can see. Wait. So she sewed that and she missed that tip a little bit.
I missed the tip.
The tip of it right here. So just have her turn it over and go from this direction and then she'll get to the edge.
I didn't do my knot.
Yeah, well now you can do it. Sew over it. Just start right there in the middle. Wait, hold this. Turn back. Okay. Put your foot down and... Oh, well.
Mm-hmm. Go back.
Go all the way to the edge, Emma. You're not going to the edge.
Don't I have to do that?
Now go back. Go backwards. Okay, good. Perfect. Did you go to the edge on this side?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me sew these edges. Excuse me. No trade spots.
Am I able to pull the string out yet?
Hold on.
Okay. I really want
to. Because you didn't go to the edge on this one.
Oh.
I just wanted
to. I think that you can sew the other one.
Okay.
And when...
All right.
Where does this go to? Does this go to Annalie's bell pin bank?
Mm-hmm. To figure out how to pull that out in a second. Emma wants to do that. And then we'll put her her snap on, and then we will be done for the evening.
After I try it on.
Yeah, she'll try it on one more time with her everything on. And then we'll go iron. Whoops. I want it. There we go. Yeah, I'll get that done.
Oh, you said you're gonna do that.
Do this side. Okay. Now, I'll just put this one like this. I don't need to pin. I did that for Emma. For Emma's sake. Put it back on straight stitch. Okay, now let me get this all lined up. Make sure all my fringes are down. You ready to come pull this out, Emma, in a second?
Uh-huh.
Sharpay, no.
No.
I was trying to figure out where the string was, and I was looking on this end.
Oh, we have to still put the binding around the neck.
Yeah. What binding?
Are you showing them how you're taking it off or not?
Pulling. How do I take it off?
Mm-hmm. Oh. You just gotta find the piece that pulls.
Oh, I just pull the strings out of it.
Okay.
Pulling the string to get all the fringe off of it. Like this. Then it's nice and floofy. Nice and floofy.
Do you do both sides?
No, I'm doing both
sides. Okay.
String. And now they're both nice and floofy.
Princess. Can you see what you're
doing? It doesn't look like how you tied it. It looks.
Okay. Alright, so now I'll show you what I just did.
Like this?
I just folded this back on both sides and I stitched up and around.
What binding are you
putting? We gotta put a binding on it now.
What's binding?
I have a white binding somewhere.
Did I leave it down? Here it is.
This is binding. And this goes around the edge. You open it up.
Ta-da.
Just like this.
And I tied it a different way. I tied it like a scarf.
And you fold it over. You could do a straight stitch. I'll probably just do a quick zigzag stitch. Then we'll have to concentrate as hard. And that is it. Yeah, like I said, you can... And you went the shorter, because normally what you would do is you would sew this on, then you would come over and fold it, sew it again. Not going to do that. I'm just going to put it on, and I'm going to do a zigzag all the way around. So let me do that really, really quick, and then Emma will try it on. Actually, I'm thinking about just leaving this long, and it's just going to have a tie in the back. How's that sound?
That's fine.
Okay.
How do I tie this around?
Hold on. Try not to play too much with it. Okay, let me over here.
Do I just...
Can you get me white thread out of the basket, please? I need white thread.
So instead of doing a snap, you're just going
to... Yeah, I changed my mind. And I still might do a snap. I might put a snap on the binding.
Yeah.
I haven't quite...
This basket.
Yes. Oh,
basket.
Yep. Now this, I do want to have thread that matches.
This is my drape.
That'll be your drape. Oh, we have to get a little bit more red. You need some more. So let me have this. So you can see I'm going to open this up and lay it up to the fold. And I'm going to place the fold over it and put it under here. And I am just going to zigzag all the way around. And that's all I'm going to do. And I left it long enough, so if I want to tie it or put a snap in it, I haven't decided which. And since the play isn't until next weekend, I technically just for tomorrow could... I could just let it tie for now. I should have done a longer zigzag, but that's okay. This is working nicely. I could have done a decorative stitch. There's so many things that I really, really could have done on it, but... Number one, it's getting late, and number two, it's something she's not going to wear again, so it, and people are not going to be up on top of her. And she can use this as a costume afterwards. She can play in it. Or I can repurpose the material. I can make pajama bottoms or something with it afterwards. I mean, there's so much more that we could do. Stopping here, though, because I'm making it a tie, I really need to take it, I would sew it farther, but until I decide for sure what I'm doing. All right, Em, come try this on. All right, let me cut this. So I'm just going to try it on, and then that's it. And try it on without your top.
It looks like our old curtain.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. You're right, Kurt.
They can't see you back there.
I'm just checking.
Well, yeah.
But the windows can.
This way it won't be so bulky around that top of the better feel. Okay.
Well, I mean, I'm going to wear a shirt under.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to wear a tank top tomorrow.
Okay. Step right here.
All right, now I need my sash. Now I need my sash.
Your
and my
sash is right here. Come right here, please.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
All
right. Let me just tie this for now. Because what I may do...
I gave you the sash. I don't have to go on.
I may just put a snap on here and then bring it over and just snap it. is what I may do. Or I may tie it. I haven't. Let me see how it looks tied. I don't think I like that. I think I'm going to snap. That looks.
Right. Hold on. What did I do?
You got it all. You got it full like that. Now, bring it over, and then. You feeling better?
Do I look like in Kayla?
Does she look like a little Israelite girl?
Yeah.
There.
I'm not. Now Drake.
No, oh, your drape. Then, though this isn't done, she will basically can have this on her like this, up and around. Whoop, let me put you up. It looks like Little Red Riding Hood, but I think she really wants it.
I wanted it like the one on there.
Like this?
The picture.
Isn't that how she has it back like that?
She has it like...
Let me get the picture. Do you see the package anywhere? Here it is. Excuse me, I'm gonna come in.
Let me see.
Yeah, that's how she has it.
That's not how she has it completely.
Let me see. So she's going for that. So basically, I mean, I don't have it on her. Let's put it like that.
I'll be able to figure out how to put it on tomorrow.
You'll have plenty of moms there to help you. I can't be there with her. I have an appointment tomorrow and I have to take my mom on.
So like that, and then it goes over your head still.
She does not have it on her head. Oh, yes, she does. Oh, so she probably has it. Let me tell you. Okay, she probably has it. It's going to be like this and then up. There's not enough of it here. I got to get some more tomorrow when I'm out. And over like that. So that's basically how... And this probably comes around and does the same thing.
So how am I wearing it tomorrow, since we don't have enough?
You're not wearing it tomorrow.
Okay.
You won't be able to wear it tomorrow.
That works.
But anyway, step back so we can show what you look like. Turn, turn, turn. Maybe we should put the, it's all the way down. And up. So we just hem her sleeves. And should we put the snap on real quick?
So we weren't doing that.
I decided. I don't like the tie. Turn around. At all. It looks...
Oh, I don't like it either.
Looks silly. Okay, so take your sash off. These are called cam snaps. They are the neatest snaps ever. What color did you decide?
And this one? I decided on...
That color? Alright.
Does it go? Put it up against it.
Not really.
No.
This color will.
Yeah, that one.
Okay.
Let me put my shirt on. Yep. Because take this.
Down there.
Am I going to have to try it on again with the thing?
Nah, you won't try it back on with the snap. Mm-hmm. So we need this piece, and this, and that. And my hole poker right here. And where's the grips? Oh, here it is.
I took those out. I forgot to put
them back in. Do you need help?
Yes, I do.
Arms up. Okay. So this is so simple to do. One will be on here.
I don't know where my lines are.
Actually, on here.
I don't know where my lines are.
I have no idea either, Emma. Hold on a second. So I'm just going to trim that.
Then again, we're not allowed to use them during it anyway, so.
Yep.
The only thing you do is look over it before.
You know what your lines are, right? Somebody will have something there.
And I know the order that it goes in.
Okay.
I just don't know who I'm after.
Alright, so I want it to go like right there. So this is a very, get my finger out of the way because I don't want to pierce my finger. So, see, we poked it through. Okay. I'm going to put this through that hole. Get it through there. It's kind of a, it's kind of thick. So. Get my hole stays. Come on now. What is the problem here? I see it. There it is. Hold on. Where did it come from? Side. There we go. There we go. There we go. See? Poke that through, and we're going to take one of these two pieces. Wait, it's about the same.
No.
That one goes into that one. So we're going to put this one on here.
Can I do that?
Hold on. You can squeeze it.
That's what I want it to do.
Yeah. Give me one sec. And squeeze. Use all your muscles. Muscles. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Wait, let me see. Looks to me like she did a really good job. Look at that.
For some reason, I thought it would make a clicking sound.
No.
I don't know why.
So then what we're going to do is take this other one. We're going to put it on there like that so that it will, so we'll put it like right here. And I think I might fold it over for an extra hold. So, right there. Okay, let me poke my hole. Poke, poke, poke. Now I want this one to come in this direction. I want this one to come up. This way. I'm gonna have to do like I did the other one, reverse it. Here's the other piece. You gonna squeeze this one?
Yep.
Okay, squeeze. Squeeze, 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 squeeze! Okay. Well, she did a good job. Looks good to me. Feels good to me too. Yeah, I didn't really have to do anything. So there we go. That's our snap. Little makeshift way that I felt worked. Just cut that. There we go. Other than her sleeves being hemmed, her costume is done.
And the drape.
Except for the drape.
The drape and the sleeve.
In any case, you can see that it is still, internet went down. You can still see how easy it is to do this. I mean, it took from start to finish, we're about 3 hours. I can't wait till I get my new modem. I think it's still good because it's working off of my phone. So, about 3 hours. By the time I go down and I by the time I hem the sleeves and then I go down and I press it, we're about 3 hours in. So, okay. Well, there you have it. I will try and get some pictures of her maybe tomorrow. I won't be there, so I'll ask somebody to take some pictures for me. Alrighty? She's going to be adorable. All right. Well, thank you for joining us. My name is Cindy, and this is...
Emma.
Emma, and we're with Nana, So's, and More. Please share. I know this was very long and probably boring, but remember, fast forward through the things that bore you. When you're not watching it live, you are able to do that. All righty. Let me make sure I put this back on here, because...
Sure.
Do not want to get poked by that. So thank you very much. And we hope that you'll share. We hope that you'll like us and follow us. That would be great. Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye.